They never spoke back when they were insulted. They worked. They never took days off that were not on the calendar. They never went on strike without permission. They worked 10 days a week and were only paid for 5. They worked, they worked, they worked, and they died. They died broke. They died owing. They died never knowing what the front entrance of the First National City Bank looked like. Juan, Miguel, Milagros, Olga, Manuel, all died yesterday, today, and will die again tomorrow. Passing their bill collectors on to the next of kin, all died waiting for the Garden of Eden to open up again under a new management. All died dreaming about America, waking them up in the middle of the night screaming, Mira, mira, your name is on the winning lottery ticket for $100,000. All died hating the grocery stores that sold them make-believe steak and bulletproof rice and beans. All died waiting, dreaming, and hating. Dead Puerto Ricans who never knew they were Puerto Ricans, who never took a coffee break from the Ten Commandments to kill, kill, kill the landlords of their crack skulls and communicate with their Latino souls. Juan, Miguel, Milagros, Olga, Manuel, from the nervous breakdown streets where the mice live like millionaires and the people do not live at all, are dead and were never alive. Juan died waiting for his number to hit. Miguel died waiting for the welfare check to come and go and come again. Milagros died waiting for her 10 children to grow up and work so she could quit working. Olga died waiting for a $5 raise. Manuel died waiting for his supervisor to drop dead so he could get a promotion. It's a long ride from Spanish Harlem to Long Island Cemetery where they were buried. First the train and then the bus and the cold cuts for lunch and the flowers that will be stolen when visiting hours are over. It's very expensive, it's very expensive, but they understand, their parents understood. It's a long non-profit ride from Spanish Harlem to Long Island Cemetery. Juan, Miguel, Milagros, Olga, Manuel, all died yesterday, today, will die again tomorrow, dreaming. Dreaming about Queens, clean-cut, lily-white neighborhoods, Puerto Rican-less scene, $30,000 home, first picks on the block, proud to belong to a community of gringos who want them lynched, proud to be a long distance away from the sacred phrase, ¿Qué pasa? These dreams, these empty dreams, from the make-believe bedrooms their parents left them are the after-effects of television programs about the ideal white American family with black maids and Latino janitors who are well-trained to make everyone and their bill collectors laugh at them and the people that they represent. They knew they were born to weep and keep the morticians employed as long as they pledge allegiance to the flag that wants them destroyed. They saw their names listed in the telephone directory of destruction. They were trained to turn the other cheek by newspapers that misspelled, mispronounced, and misunderstood their names and celebrated when death came. Puerto Rico is a beautiful place. Puerto Ricanos are a beautiful race. If only they had turned off the television and tuned into their own imaginations. If only they had used the white supremacy Bibles for toilet paper purposes and made their Latino souls the only religion of their race. Juan, Miguel, Milagros, Olga, Manuel, who might not be doing their own thing, where beautiful people sing and dance and work together, where the wind is a stranger to miserable weather conditions, where you do not need a dictionary to communicate with your people. Aquí se habla español all the time. Aquí you salute your flag first. Aquí there are no dial-soap commercials. Aquí everybody smell good. Aquí TV dinner do not have a future. Aquí the men and women admire, desire, and never get tired of each other. Aquí que pasa power is what's happening. Aquí to be called negrito means to be called love.
Hot.